So will he or won't he run for president? Texas Governor Rick Perry is the guy we're talking about. He's holding off on announcing an official White House bid, but telling one newspaper just this weekend that running for the Republican nomination may be his calling. Perry getting some support in a recent Quinnipiac poll, 10% of voters saying they'd vote for him if a GOP primary were held today. Joining us now, roll call columnist and editor of the Rothenberg Political Report, Stuart Rothenberg. So Stuart, if you read the governor's tea leaves, what's he saying here?
Well, every insider that I talk to thinks they think that he's going to run. He's giving every indication that he's going to run. Of course, until he announces, he's not in the race, but we all expect him to be a candidate.
Well, here is what you wrote back about a month ago or so in June. You wrote that he looks the part of a politician, even down to his hair. He gets a lot of attention for his hair, doesn't he?
He does, but hair aside, he's an interesting fit in this race. Look, this is a race where there's something of a vacuum, and I hear tell that nature abhors a vacuum, and the vacuum is on the conservative side. There are governors in this race, and there are conservatives. Rick Perry is a conservative governor, so he definitely has a position in this race if he wants it.
So if he jumps in, who gets hurt the most?
Well, I think the question is on the right, who is damaged the most, and at the moment, well, two people are probably hurt. At the moment, Michelle Bachmann's got all the buzz on the political right. Rick Perry gets in. He's going to try to appeal to many of those same kind of voters. The other person who I think is probably hurt is Tim Pawlenty, who has had a rough few weeks, some would say a few months now. He has always tried to position himself just to Mitt Romney's right, to make himself the governor who is acceptable to conservatives. Rick Perry gets in the race, and it really, really preempts a lot of what Tim Pawlenty's been trying to do.
He has been elected governor three times. He brags about the fact that half the jobs created in this country over the last decade or so have been created in Texas. I mean, he's got an awful lot going for him. The one rub you point out might be that, I guess, the question about whether America is ready to elect another ex-governor from Texas or former Texas governor as president.
Right. He has a good story. The job story is a good one, and obviously that's the major concern, both with Republicans and the public at large. The question is, yes, are we ready for somebody to follow in George W. Bush's footsteps? Now, let's be clear that the Perry folks and the Bush folks haven't always gotten along. There's a lot of competition there. But I had a Republican insider say to me, if you think that George W. Bush was a cowboy, Rick Perry is twice the cowboy. Again, will that sell this time? It's not entirely clear.
You say that he is even more conservative than George W. Bush was. True?
Oh, yeah, no, absolutely. He's not only more conservative, but he's more anti-Washington, anti-establishment. President Bush, the second President Bush, certainly generally qualifies as a conservative in terms of the role of government, muscular U.S. foreign policy, traditional values, things like that. Rick Perry is even more so, but in terms of his rhetoric in taking on Washington, in taking on government, he goes far beyond what George W. Bush did. And let's remember, George W. Bush, for all his conservatism, came out of kind of the establishment. I mean, his father was a president, an Ivy League kind of guy with a lot of friends in the oil business. Rick Perry is the outsider who beats up on Washington and everybody in the establishment.
Well, he wrote that book a year or so ago. He titled it Fed Up, and that was all about how Washington is dominating way too much of the system in this country.
And that's a pretty good message in a Republican primary or Iowa caucus, isn't it? Republicans are really fed up with Washington, and as the governor of Texas, he can make that argument. He can say that he has had responsibility to run a state. He's, in terms of the economy, economic and job growth, and yet he's anti-bureaucracy, anti-D.C. It should be an effective message.
The Iowa caucuses, though, are just around the corner. Can he jump into it, you know, without much of a campaign operation in place in Iowa, and still expect to do well?
Well, he can't jump into the upcoming Iowa straw poll, which is in the middle of August, and there's talk that he'll wait until after that or right before to announce, and he won't compete there. But yeah, no, I think there's an opportunity. He still has an opportunity in February or January, whenever the Iowa caucuses are going to be. They're supposed to be in February, although the calendar is still in flux. He is a great campaigner. That's what everybody tells me. They say maybe he doesn't enjoy governing as much as he does campaigning, but he is a terrific campaigner. He is a stem winder. He's great on the back of a truck, speaking out of a bullhorn. I look at him to be a strong campaigner in Iowa.
Stuart Rothenberg from Roll Call and the Rothenberg Political Report. Stuart, thank you.